Hello students, welcome to the next lecture of Emerging Domain in Electronics Engineering. In today's lecture, we will discuss the slew rate and the ideal and practical characteristics of op-amp. In the previous lecture, we have discussed the common mode rejection ratio of op-amp and some numericals also we did in the previous lecture on CMRR. I hope you all must have understood it. Now let us move to the another feature of op-amp, that is the slew rate. So let us understand what is slew rate. See, slew rate is the maximum rate at which amplifier output can change in volts per microsecond. So remember that slew rate, it is denoted as sometimes as SR, and it is the maximum rate at which the output of the op-amp or amplifier output can change with respect to the time. So that time that will be always taken in microseconds. So it is, the unit will be always volt per microsecond. So that is about the slew rate, a basic definition of slew rate, maximum rate of change of output with respect in volts per microsecond. So that is the, you can simply define it by looking to the formula. Now, sometimes question might be asked upon maximum signal frequency. Maximum signal frequency. What is maximum signal frequency? Okay. So what is maximum signal frequency? It is the maximum frequency at which an output or an op-amp may operate depends upon the bandwidth and the slew rate of op-amp. So always remember, the maximum frequency at which an op-amp may operate, that will always depend upon the bandwidth and the slew rate of op-amp. Okay, so what is the bandwidth? Bandwidth is given by omega. So for a sinusoidal signal, because when you will get the output of an op-amp, so first of all I will write the heading, the maximum frequency, the maximum frequency at which an op-amp may operate, an op-amp may operate, it depends upon the bandwidth and slew rate of op-amp. So for a sinusoidal signal, V naught will be a sinusoidal signal. And how do we represent a sinusoidal signal? We represent it by some amplitude into sine omega t. So let the amplitude here be k into sine of omega t. I am opening omega, that is 2 pi f t. Now the maximum rate of change of voltage can be, the maximum rate of change of voltage, rate of change of voltage can be, it can be k into 2 pi f volt per second. It can be k into 2 pi f volt per second, because it will be take, k is the maximum value and omega is the frequency. So the maximum frequency or the maximum rate of change, you can either take volt per second, volt upon time, and 1 upon time is frequency. So you can take frequency also. So k into 2 pi f, or you can say k omega volt per second. So to prevent distortion, the above value should not exceed the slew rate. The above should not exceed the slew rate. Should not exceed the slew rate. The above should not exceed the slew rate. Okay, so what should we write? We should write here that we have written k 2 pi f and it should not exceed slew rate. That means what we can say? We can say k omega is less than or equal to slew rate, and omega is less than or equal to slew rate divided by the amplitude. And then omega is given as radian per second. So sometimes you might be asked to calculate the maximum signal at which the distortion will not be, a maximum frequency of the signal at which the distortion can be avoided. So you will be given the slew rate and you will be asked to calculate the maximum frequency. So in that case, you can use this concept. So let us do a numerical on it. For the signal and the circuit shown, determine the maximum frequency, that may be used, okay, and the slew rate given is 0.5 volt per microsecond. Okay, so you have the circuit like this. It is given in the numerical itself. Vi is given as 0.02 volt and omega is simply given as omega I is simply given as 300 into 10 raised to the power 3. Okay, so you are asked to calculate the maximum frequency. We have already learnt in the previous topic that omega should be less than slew rate divided by k. And what is k? K is equals to the output. We saw that V naught equals to some amplitude into sine of omega t, that is 2 pi f into t. So what was k? K is the maximum value of V naught, and what is V naught? Equals to A into gain into Vi, that we saw in the first lecture of op-amp. So I have shared the links in the description box. So that is A into Vi. So K is A into Vi. Okay, now we need to calculate A for this, and this is an inverting amplifier which we haven't studied yet. So only for this numerical, just remember that A is going to be simply, this is RF, just look at the circuit diagram, this is RF feedback resistor and this is R1. Just remember gain will be RF by R1, which you will understand in the further lecture. Okay, so how this gain is RF upon R1. So RF by R1, so it will be 240K divided by 10K and it will be 24 like this. So if you calculate K, it will be 24 into 0.02 volt and it will be 0.48. So the omega is going to be less than or equal to the slew rate divided by K. That means omega is less than or equal to 0.5 divided by 0.48, and this 0.5 was in volt per microsecond. So I'm going to open it up into seconds, that is radian per second. So it is going to be like this, and omega will be less than or equal to 1.04 into 10 raised to the power 6 radian per second. So this is the answer that is going to. So just forget about it, that how A is equals to RF by R1, because you are going to understand it in the next lecture. In the coming lectures, in the next one or two lectures, you will be understanding how this gain is RF by R1, because we haven't studied the negative feedback yet. And the circuit drawn in front of you is of negative feedback, where you are feeding the output back to the negative input. That is why it is called a negative feedback. So just leave it, just only remember that A is, in this case, as we look to the circuit, it is a circuit where the gain will be equal to RF by R1. Now let us see the ideal op-amp characteristics. We have been already discussing in the previous lectures that when we will talk about an ideal circuit, then the things that we were considering to be high will be considered as infinite, and the things that we were considering low, they will be considered zero in the case of ideal. So when we will talk about ideal circuit, we will talk in two terms, that is infinite and zero. So let us recall one by one. Let us start from the very first definition of op amp, that op amp is a very high gain differential amplifier. We talked about it like this. So I have also shared the description of the link in the description box of the first lecture of op amp, where we discussed all these things. So the gain, that is when we talked about that it has a it is a circuit that has high differential gain. So the open loop gain of op amp, that is A, is equal to infinity. First feature is this. Second, we also talked about that it has high input impedance. So input impedance of an ideal op amp, that is Zi, is equal to infinity. We also talked that the output impedance is low. So output impedance that is Z naught is equal to zero. It will be zero because it was low in the case of practical op amp. CMRR of an ideal op amp, it has to be high, so infinite for ideal. Slew rate, again it has to be high, again infinite for ideal. Bandwidth of an op amp, that from which frequency to which frequency an op amp will work, it has to be high. So again, it has to be infinite for an ideal op amp. And the offset voltage for an ideal op amp, that is low. Now, first of all, let us understand what is offset voltage. Offset voltage means when you switch off a circuit, you should not get any output voltage. And if you are getting an output voltage, that means that you are getting some offset voltage. So the offset voltage for an ideal op amp is low, and that is what is desirable. So offset voltage is zero for an ideal op amp. So op amp is a very high gain differential amplifier. Therefore, the open loop gain is infinity. The input impedance is high, so therefore it is infinity. The output impedance is low, therefore it is zero. CMRR and slew rate is high, therefore they are infinite. Bandwidth is again high for an op amp, so therefore it is infinite for an ideal op amp. And offset voltage is zero. Now let's talk about the practical op amp characteristics. What about practical op amp characteristics? So first point, we talked about the gain of an op amp. So the open loop gain of an op amp is in the range of thousands. It is in the range of thousands. That means you get a very high op amp. And if you talk about 741 IC, it is in the range of 2 into 10 raised to the power 5. So high. Now, if you talk about input impedance, it is in the range of mega ohms. That is 10 raised to the power 6 mega. So that is again very high. Output impedance, it is very, very low, and it is in few ohms. If you talk about CMRR, it is very high, and in decibels, it is approximately 90 decibels for 741 IC. If we talk about slew rate, it is very high. If you talk about slew rate bandwidth, then it is very, very high, and it is in few hundred kilohertz. Kilohertz. And if we talk about offset voltage, it is very, very low, and it is in millivolts. So when we discussed the practical op amp characteristics, so we discussed the ranges of the different parameters, and we saw that the things that we consider to be high are infinite are very high, and the things which we consider to be zero, they are very low. So we saw the ranges of different parameters for op amp here. So I hope that these topics of op amp must be clear to you. Thank you.